From exotic, colorful, genetically engineered glowing fish to large and tasty sunfish, here are mysterious and weird species of fish.
Hey guys, how's it going? I'm your host, American Eye, keeping an eye on everything you want to know.
The Devil's Hole Pupfish. This strange fish isn't found in the ocean, but actually in a place where you least expect it. Nevada certainly isn't a state that's known for its fishing, but that's the state where you'll find the Devil's Hole Pupfish. They dwell in a water-filled cavern and have a striking blue sapphire color, but they're also notable for their pelvic fins, which are quite rare. The small fish will eat just about everything that lives in the cave, ranging from beetles, snails, larvae, and even algae. Some people have criticized the government for wanting to protect the fish at all costs, which included preserving their groundwater. Any slight changes to their water source could mean their end, which is why they're so closely monitored. Nearly $5 million has been spent on equipment to help keep it alive. This comes with much confusion of many people. In April of 2016, some unexpected environment vandalism took place when three men broke into the cavern and partially destroyed their habitat. The spotted handfish. Wait, hold on a minute. Fish don't have hands, do they? Think again. This rare fish from Australia actually does, and it kind of shows us how hands can develop from fins after enough time goes by. Their pectoral fins had developed to the point where they can actually walk with them on the seafloor. They're still trying to get used to their new limbs and aren't really known for crawling around too fast. Their habitat is very limited to only streams in Tasmania, but can lay up to 250 eggs at a time, depending on the size of the pouch. As of right now, they're critically endangered, which is possibly due to the fact that they can't escape predators very quickly. They could certainly use some natural defenses. Could it be possible that this creature will someday morph into a human fish-like species and grow some legs in the near future? Who knows? The lionfish. This commonly found venomous fish is found off the coast of Florida and the Carolinas, mostly due to the exportation from the Indian Ocean. People like having them in their aquariums, but not so much, and sometimes leave them in the ocean. They were able to invade our coastlines when they were introduced to our oceans. They have thrived in our environment and are now considered an invasive creature. Interaction with humans can be very deadly too. Their poisonous fins make them deadly to scuba divers or fishermen who are unlucky enough to get pricked. Symptoms of a sting can include vomiting, fever, breathing problems, dizziness, and even paralysis in some cases. Some have the idea that these creatures could be fished and eaten, but the idea hasn't caught on just yet. The dragonfish. It almost looks like a normal fish until you see its teeth. Then you realize that this thing must live at the bottom of the ocean. It's noticeable with its snake-like body and sharp needle-like teeth. Not only are the teeth extremely sharp, but they also have the capability of growing from their tongues. These fish can grow to be about 2 feet long and are certainly found at the depths of the ocean. They can go as low as 5,000 feet, but prefer shallower depths at night. Their colors may vary on what region they choose as their habitat, such as green, silver, and black. The fang-like teeth paralyzes the victim, and they enjoy eating lanternfish and also bristlemouse. Piranhas. A piranha is also something you really don't want to get bit by. The jaws are quite powerful, considering the size of the fish, but the razor-sharp teeth are what will normally do the damage. Be careful what body of water you decide to go swimming in. The bite of a piranha measures at about 70 pounds of force at the tip of its teeth. That means a piranha's bite force is about 20 times its body weight. To put that into comparison, the great white's bite force matches its own weight. Native to the Amazon River, these carnivorous fish are known for ripping apart the flesh of anything it comes into contact with. So I guess you can say this fish packs a lot of punch for its size. The ocean sunfish. Known to be one of the largest and boniest fish out in the sea, this species is found in subtropical areas and is quite difficult to tell exactly what it is without closely looking at it. They're pretty friendly creatures and typically just enjoy a diet of squid, baby fish, and other crustaceans. Injuries from sunfish are rather rare, but they have been known to leap out and hit people who are on boats, which might be as hilarious as it sounds. It would certainly not be a jokey manner though if one of them hits your propeller, which can seriously damage your boat. Then you might be stuck and surrounded by shark bait. The population of this fish has slightly decreased due to their large size and their problems escaping fishing nets. There's also the issue of becoming susceptible to parasites, considering how big and vulnerable they are. Nonetheless, they aren't considered to be endangered and are only classified as threatened at the moment. This photo here shows a sunfish that was captured in 1910 and managed to weigh in at 3,500 pounds. Now that's a lot of fish sticks. The red-lipped batfish. This strange-looking fish looks like it just put on some lipstick and is waiting for you to give it a big kiss. But don't be so easily seduced. This thing could certainly be an alien waiting for a human to abduct and put into their spaceship. This is another bottom-dwelling ocean creature who can seemingly walk on the seafloor with its 4 feet. Are there really any other animals that can do that? These are found off the coast of the Galapagos Islands, and you have to wonder if this thing maybe helped out Charles Darwin's theory that ocean animals were able to grow legs, walk, and survive on land. It's just missing some lungs, and this thing could eventually evolve into a human. Could it possibly be the missing link? Who knows? Giant frogfish. Also known as the Commerson's frogfish, this thing has a face like a frog, but the body of a fish, which can actually make it look pretty creepy at times. It can grow 15 inches in length and has a blob-like body. Its body is covered in dermal spinules, which actually act like tiny little spikes. It has a rather large mouth, which allows it to eat a wide variety of different ocean creatures, primarily other fish, who cross its path. Since the frogfish primarily inhabits subtropical climates, it can find shelter in coral reefs. There is no fairy tale ending for the giant frogfish, and they only associate with the female species for the act of reproduction. Once that is over with, the female might attack the male or even eat him. Once that is over with, the female frogfish might attack the male or even eat him if he sticks around for too long. Independent frogfish women don't need no man. The sawfish. No, that's not a chainsaw attached to a fish. That's actually the snout of a species known as the sawfish. The spikes coming out of it are its teeth, and they use their large sharp snouts to dig under the ocean floor and search for small creatures to eat. They can also catch fish like small herring with these instruments of destruction. Also, if the sawfish loses a tooth, it's not a big deal. They'll regenerate it over time and grow throughout its lifespan. Watching this thing hunt with its incredible snout is quite a sight to see, and they're absolutely merciless, capable of ripping fish into pieces with one slash. The sawtooth fish tends to live in warmer climates too. These huge sharks can grow over 18 feet long and weigh up to 700 pounds. They typically don't have any predators besides humans, but the young ones can be attacked by larger fish and even dolphins. The barrel-eyed fish. The spooky thing about this fish could be that its head is transparent, allowing you to see its brain. This intriguing fish has barrel-shaped tubular eyes that are extremely sensitive to light, which is why it prefers to live at the bottom of the ocean. The eyes are generally directed upward, so instead of looking forward, it's normally looking to the top of the ocean, but can also be directed forwards. The eyes are quite powerful for a fish, and they're lucky that a transparent dome covers them. If you caught one of these while fishing, you'd probably throw it back in the ocean immediately. The flying fish. Is it a bird? Is it a plane? Oh wait, it's just a fish with wings. Nothing to see here. This fish out of water is quite mysterious, since it can both swim and fly. Fish that don't fly seem to be the most vulnerable prey in the ocean. I'm sure sometimes they wish they can just spread their wings and fly. Well, some fish actually can, if you didn't know. These fish don't just jump in the air for a while, these fish can actually fly over 50 meters. This marine animal evolved in order to fly and escape predators by being able to outsmart them and outmaneuver them. However, they aren't able to escape the human type. The Japanese like to make them into a type of sushi called tobiko. Glowfish. These glowfish are the first genetically engineered pets on the market to become available to the public, but that doesn't mean you'll find them everywhere. Jellyfish DNA, or DNA from other sea creatures, will be inserted into the embryos of zebrafish. This results in some of them being able to glow in the dark. Other DNA from coral, sea anemone, and also sea pansy are introduced to make them glow different colors. They were extremely popular and flew off of shelves in Taiwan, selling for $18 each. It's believed that they're originally created to be released into the water and become fluorescent when toxic water is present. Some people protested the fish, like in Canada, but eventually it was deemed that they weren't too dangerous. Many fish also have some natural fluorescence, so there hasn't been any negative side effects just yet. The sarcastic fringehead. This fish poses no harms to humans whatsoever, unless you get easily offended by sarcasm. So what turns out to be the problem for most people is actually this fish's defense mechanism. This strange-looking thing actually scares off predators by opening its large, colorful mouth. When two territorial sarcastic fringeheads meet, they sort of end up fighting each other with their mouths, almost like they're kissing. They also grow up to be about a foot long and tend to live at the bottom of the Western Pacific Ocean, going about 240 feet deep. And number 1, the giant sea bass. Whoa, this bass in the photo looks big enough to eat the little kid. She must be a really good fisherwoman. Giant sea bass can reach the size of 8 feet long and weigh as much as 562 pounds. Some of these mega bass have been located in the Gulf of California to Catalina Island, and they can live as long as 75 years if no one can reel them in. They feast on a steady diet of other fish and can eat small crustaceans too. Some believe with the popularity of sports fishing, these giant bass's sea numbers are dwindling, with maybe only 500 left.
Whoa, now that was a cool video. Make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe, and we'll see you next time.